Hello everyone, I'm Renu. Today let's think about family, and this family is about God's family. We all live in a family and we share each other, we love each other, and we have a strong bond, right? But here God wants a family, and He created you to be a part of it. And this is God, or God's purpose for your life, which He planned before you were born. See how very much our Heavenly Father loves us, for He allows us to be called His children, and we really are. 1 John chapter 3 verse 1. The entire Bible is a story of God building a family who will love Him, honor Him, and reign with Him forever. God has always existed in loving relationship to Himself, so He has never been lonely. He didn't need a family, He desired one. The Bible says, "It was a happy day for Him when He gave us our new lives through the truth of His word, and we became, as it were, the first children in His new family." Every human being was created by God, but not everyone is a child of God. The only way to get into God's family is by being born again into it. You became part of the human family by your first birth, but you become a member of God's family by your second birth. And this invitation to be a part of God's family is universal. But there is one condition. And what's that condition? Faith in Jesus. The Bible says, "You are all children of God through faith in Jesus Christ." Your spiritual family is even more important than your physical family, because it will last forever. Our families on earth are wonderful gifts from God, but they are temporary and fragile, often broken by divorce, distance, growing old, and inevitably death. On the other hand, our spiritual family will continue throughout eternity. It is a much stronger union, a more permanent bond than blood relationships. And there are some benefits of being in God's family. And what are those benefits? First one is we'll get to be with God forever. And second one is we will be completely changed to be like Christ. Third one is we'll be freed from all pain, death, and suffering. Fourth one is we'll be rewarded and reassigned positions of service. Fifth is we'll get to share in Christ's glory. The Bible says God has reserved a priceless inheritance for His children. It is kept in heaven for you, pure and undefiled, beyond the reach of change and decay. What does this mean? This means that your eternal inheritance is priceless, pure, permanent, and protected. No one can take it from you. It can't be destroyed by war, a poor economy, or a natural disaster. And this inheritance is what you should be looking forward to and working for. Baptism signifies your inclusion in God's family. And your baptism declares your faith, shares Christ's burial and resurrection, symbolizes your death to your old life, and announces your new life in Christ. Baptism doesn't make you a member of God's family. It shows you are a part of God's family. In the New Testament, people were baptized as soon as they believed. At Pentecost, 3,000 were baptized the same day they accepted Christ. Being included in God's family is the highest honor and the greatest privilege you will receive. Nothing else comes close. Whenever you feel unimportant, unloved, or insecure, remember to whom you belong. So, let me conclude by saying that love your family, love your God, be faith in Jesus Christ, and He will love you